Hello children, today we are doing the question answers of the chapter Mauvi's Kite by Thomas Anthony Tommy DePaola. So we are doing the question answers under the heading Understanding the Text. So on the basis of your understanding of the chapter, you have to answer these questions. I have already explained the story in my previous video with the help of the pictures, so that you can understand the story. So let's begin with question number 1. How did Mauvi build his kite? So if you remember the story, Mauvi used 3 things to make his kite. To build his kite means to make his kite. He used a cloth given by his mother. He used bamboo sticks to make the frame of the kite. And he used the branches of the Olona shrub to make a strong rope. So the answer to this question is, Mauvi built a grand kite for himself by using his mother's largest, strongest piece of cloth for the covering, bamboo sticks for the cross pieces, and the branches of the Olona shrub to make a strong rope. Now, question number 2. Why did Mauvi go to the keeper of the winds? So, if you all remember, Mauvi went to the keeper of the winds for a special wind so that he could fly his kite. So, the answer to this question is, Mauvi went to the keeper of the winds because he wanted to ask for a special wind which would make his kite fly really high. Okay children, now let's move to question number 3. What advice did the speaker give to Mauvi and his friends? So what was the advice given by the keeper of the winds? Answer to this question is, the keeper of the winds advised Mauvi and his friends to respect the winds and to never take them for granted. She told them that the winds would respect them only if they were respected in return. Now children, in this question, I would like to tell you why these two spellings are different. Let's do a little grammar in this question. This is advice and this is advised. So here, A-D-V-I-C-E, advice. This is noun, salah dena, okay? And here, we are using advised. When the spelling is A-D-V-I-S-E, then it is a verb. So, don't get confused. Here, we are using this word as a verb. Here, we are using this word as a noun. So, this is the difference between these two words. Now, what advice did the keeper give to Mauvi and his friends? Here, we are using a noun, advice. The keeper of the winds advised Mauvi and his friends to respect the winds and to never take them for granted. In this sentence, here, this advised is used as a verb. Now let's move to question number 4. What caused the storm? What was the reason that there was a storm in the village? What was the reason? Mauvi, he did not listen to the keeper of the winds and he thought that he was as strong as the winds and he disrespected them. So, now the winds became uncontrollable. So the question to this the answer to this question is, Mauvi's greed. What was the greed? To fly kite. Okay, to fly more of kite. So Mauvi's greed and his belief that he was as strong as the winds led him to disrespect them. He demanded the keeper of the winds to bring out Ipu Nui, the god which held the 4 great winds. When she refused to do so, he called out the winds himself. But once the winds were unleashed, he was unable to control them or Ipunui, and they caused a huge storm in the village. Now children, if you remember the story, we came across in the story that there were two gods. One was Ipuiki, the other one was Ipunui. Okay. Ipuiki was holding the gentle wind or the gentle breeze. Ipunui was holding all the four great winds from all the four directions. Now, this boy, Maui, he sang the song even when the keeper of the winds, she refused it. But still he sang the song, and when all the winds were out, they were uncontrollable and it caused huge storm in the village. Okay children, let's move to question number 5. How did Maui come to be known as the teacher of the weather? So the answer to this question is, after the great storm, everyone in the village stopped talking to Maui. Finding himself alone, he built a smaller kite for himself, which he flew near his house. He would often tie it to a rock and study its movements in the sky. Soon, he became an expert in predicting weather conditions. He warned people when it was about to rain or when a storm was approaching. And since his predictions came true, villagers began to rely on his advice and started respecting him once again. It was in this way that Maui came to be called the teacher of the weather. So children, I hope you have understood these question answers. Thank you.